If you drive down PCH in Huntington Beach, you will pass the only power plant in Orange County, located at Newland and PCH, across the street from the beach. The natural gas plant is owned by AES, a leading global power company with 132 plants in 32 countries with $17 billion in revenue. In California, it operates two other natural gas plants in Los Alamitos and Redondo Beach, as well as five wind stations. The plant in Huntington Beach was purchased from Southern California Edison in 1998 and has been in operation since 1958. It uses conventional GM steam turbines, among others. In 2001, the company petitioned to upgrade and then turn on gas burners 3 and 4, which would bring the capacity up to 904 megawatts. They were successful, and in 2002, the city valued the plant at $325 million. We do seem to be pretty lucky, since I can't find no reports of explosions, leaks, waste dumps, or the like. Even the fuel, natural gas, is by far the cleanest and abundant in this country. The combustion of natural gas emits almost 30% less carbon dioxide than oil and just under 45% less carbon dioxide than coal. As for cooling, the location of the plant offers it easy access to ocean water. But it has gotten into trouble after a 2007 ruling requires power plants to reduce by 95% any marine life damage they cause. Their best option would be to operate a closed-loop system where water is reused, more energy is created, and only 5% is lost during operations. This system is obviously the best, but also the most expensive. AES has until 2020 to make these changes and looks to be doing so. In a first step, they sold two of the four turbines to Edison Mission so they can build a plant in the City of Industry. After those turbines are gone, AES plans to modernize the plant and possibly even remove the smokestacks. So what does the City of Huntington Beach, what is the role of the Chamber of Commerce? Variety and scope of chamber activities are unlimited. The Chamber represents and promotes the area's business economy and encourages business and industrial investment, broadening the tax base and providing employment. To business prospects and newcomers, the Chamber represents the community's pride and self-image. Chambers of Commerce are increasingly involved in non-commercial areas such as education, human relations, environmental, cultural, and governmental concerns. These challenges have caused Chambers of Commerce to become a viable force in seeking solutions to today's social problems. Chambers of Commerce influence national, state, and local legislation affecting business. So it would seem that the Chamber of Commerce, as well as the city itself, would be very happy that the Huntington Beach Power Plant is up and running again, at least for the time being. It is generating revenue. So now I'm going to go to the reason why I'm making this video, and that is when I attended the NRC public meeting regarding the restart plan for the San Onofre Nuclear Generating Station restart. And so the public was allowed to ask questions.
Yes.
Good evening, thank you. My name is Diane Tompson. I'm the chairman of the board of the Huntington Beach Chamber of Commerce.
Okay, this is Diane Tompson, chairman of the board of the Huntington Beach Chamber of Commerce. And let me just say, this woman does not in any way, shape, or form represent my city, me, or the other citizens of this city in a very appropriate light.
I have one quick comment and a question. Recently, the Huntington Beach City Council had the resolution about songs on its agenda, and it voted not to do anything. It voted not to sign it.
Right there. They did not vote. They agreed to stay neutral. And you're going to hear people in the background yelling that they did not vote on this. So that's strike number one against Diane Tompson.
It decided it was best to let the PUC and the NRC do its job without inner politicizing. To my question, I understand that the NRC's sole mission is safety, not cost or reliability of the electrical system, just safety. My concern is turning an established regulatory process into a circus like we have tonight.
So she's calling this a circus. There were no problems. This was a very civil meeting with concerned citizens and mayors and council members from all over Southern California, concerned citizens. It was a very level playing field. It was not a circus. Strike number two to Diane Tompson.
In the interest of safety, Californians cannot afford to allow anti-nuclear activists to hijack a thorough, rigorous process that is founded in safety.
So, right there, she's saying that Californians cannot afford anti-nuclear activists. But yet, the Huntington Beach Power Station is making money. So whose side is she on? She's obviously not on the side of her city, considering she is chairman of the board.
What is the NRC doing to ensure the integrity of its own regulatory process? Thank you.
So again, I'm going to say, I was very concerned that there's somebody like this standing up representing me. I was there. And I will be sending this video to many of the people that I know who live in Huntington Harbor, which is the ground force in revenue for the city of Huntington Beach in these multi-million dollar homes and the people who live in them and the businesses that they own. I will be sending this to many, many people and seeing if they agree with me that we should have someone like this going to public meetings and representing us inappropriately. Huntington Beach is made up of an enormous amount of amazingly kind, you know, people. They're low key. Everybody likes to be outside. There's all kinds of things to do here other than just going to the beach. We also have an awful lot of revenue from all of the oil platforms that are out in the water, out in the ocean, off the coast, as well as the foundation of Huntington Beach, which was based on and still is oil. We have an amazing park that's over 520 acres. I mean, it's a beautiful place to live. We have farmers markets. This is a sunset picture at our new mall that they just built. And of course, the beach. We have a special beach just devoted to people that can take their dogs to a special area. So, I don't, I'm just really not sure what she was thinking, because this is not anything like any of the people that I know in Huntington Beach, especially anybody who is involved with the city. As always, God bless.